Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing good. So today I'm going to speak about the diffusion limited and the perfusion limited respiratory physiology. Okay, so you see the partial pressure of oxygen in the atmosphere is 160. When it comes down to the alveoli, it decreases to 100, right? And the pulmonary capillary, which comes to the lungs alveoli for oxygenation, initially the partial pressure of oxygen was 40. Then later on, when it gets oxygenated, it becomes 95. And carbon dioxide, which was initially 46, has decreased to 40. Okay, so you can see in perfusion limited, what happens is initially it is a deoxygenated blood which comes to the alveoli. So because of the huge difference in partial pressure difference, like 140, so what happened? All the oxygen will move from the alveoli into the pulmonary capillary and diffusion is there. But you know, once it may gets the equilibrium, once it has reached 100, there can be no more flow of oxygen, right? And so the only way to increase the diffusion of oxygen is by increasing the perfusion, is by bringing in more deoxygenated blood, and thereby the oxygen can diffuse into the capillaries. Similarly, for carbon dioxide, we see that the partial pressure of carbon dioxide, which is initially 46, has reached an equilibrium at 40, and there's no more diffusion of carbon dioxide. So the only way it can increase is by bringing in more blood flow, increasing the blood flow. So that was perfusion limited normally for oxygen and carbon dioxide. Now coming to diffusion limited. Diffusion limited is seen in conditions like pulmonary fibrosis, because of the thickening of the alveolar membrane, thereby increasing the distance through which the oxygen has to diffuse. And it's also seen in conditions like emphysema, where the surface area for diffusion is decreased. So the diffusion of oxygen is limited in conditions like fibrosis, emphysema. And because of this less oxygen, you can see over here, before the equilibrium of oxygen in the capillaries reached 100, right? But now from 40, it is just reaching midway between 40 and 100, around 60 to 70, like that. So you can see that the partial pressure of oxygen is reduced in the capillaries. And because of this, decreased oxygen is going to systemic circulation and can result in hypoxemia. Okay, now next, diffusion limited is seen in carbon monoxide poisoning. So what happens in carbon monoxide poisoning? When we inhale the fumes of carbon monoxide, the partial pressure of carbon monoxide in the alveoli increases, right? But when it enters the capillaries, it binds with a hemoglobin, forming carboxyhemoglobin. And this entity, carboxyhemoglobin, does not exert any partial pressure. So the partial pressure of carbon monoxide does not increase in the capillaries. As a result, the partial pressure doesn't equalize. Thereby, there is a constant flow of carbon monoxide from the alveoli into the capillaries. So this is diffusion limited. And so diffusion limited is seen in restrictive diseases like fibrosis and emphysema in exercise for oxygen, and it's also seen for carbon monoxide. Whereas perfusion limited, that means if you want to increase the diffusion, you need to improve the blood flow, that is seen for oxygen and carbon monoxide normally. Please do like, share and subscribe. Thank you.